going to use this Google sheet that I created to see if I can find the price pattern for Penn National Gaming stock throughout the week from Monday to Friday. And in order to do that, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come back to this, but I'm going to look at these weekday stats. And what these weekday stats show, and I'm going to highlight this top section, is it actually shows the average price for each day of the week. And right now I'm looking at the past 90 days. And what I want to see is how the average price changes for each day of the week. All right, and then over here, it's actually telling me which day has the lowest average and which day has the highest average. Now, starting with the open prices, all right, we can see that the open price has the lowest price on Monday, lowest average, and then on Friday, it has the highest average. And if you look across, you see that the numbers are going up for the most part from Monday to Friday. Okay, it did go down a little here, this average. So these are very close together, but we can see the difference from Monday average to Friday average. We can see the difference, all right? It's about a $2 difference if we round it off. Now, right, 73 to 75. If I look at the low, it's similar pretty much to the open. It's Monday, Friday, and it's kind of a similar pattern here, all right, open and low. But if I look at the high now, the high price, I see that the high also is following that pattern. See how the numbers are just going up, 74.23, 74.97, 75.66, 76.11, but the difference here is that we see it drops off on Friday, right? So we see that this average Thursday price just drops off on Friday, all right, into a lower price. And then if we look at the closing prices for the week, it's the same thing. They go up from Monday to Tuesday, they go up to Wednesday, they go up a bit more to Thursday, and then I see the average again kind of drops off here on to Friday. So now the question becomes, this gets really interesting, because the question becomes, well, is this a normal thing? I mean, does this average really show me the normal behavior? Because if it does, what it suggests is that I could pretty much in general most of the time buy this stock if I'm doing short-term trading on Monday and say, you know, somewhere in the area of the closing price, and then if I were to typically sell it on Thursday, I could expect it to be at a higher price and make a profit, right? So it could be helpful information in trading, right? So now what I'm going to do is look at the actual data, right, the actual numbers, the actual prices, and see if I see the pattern that is suggested by the average. So what I'm going to do is look at each Monday to Friday grouping, just the open, low, high, and close prices. I'm going to highlight them and just take a look. So remember, the closing price we saw was Monday, was the average, the lowest average was Monday and the highest average was Thursday, right? And then it dropped off on Friday. So I'm going to look at these closing prices and see if they're going up from Monday to Thursday. So generally, I do see that they are going up on this particular week from Monday to Thursday. I see it went down just a little bit Thursday, but basically from here to here, it went up, right? Not a whole lot, but it did. Okay, but in this case, it actually, yeah, and then it dropped off a little bit here on Friday. Okay, I'm going to look at the week after that, June 28th, okay, the week here, and I'm looking at these closing prices again. Now, in this case, it went up from Monday to Tuesday. It went up again from Tuesday to Wednesday, all right? It went down a little bit from Wednesday to Thursday, but overall, it is higher. It did go up from between Monday and Thursday. It went up, right, which is what we saw in the average price, and then we see it kind of tailored off on Friday, how it kind of drops on Friday here, all right? Just a reminder that that is what we saw here with the average closing price between Thursday and Friday, as it kind of dropped off, right? I'm going to look at another Monday to Friday group. Now, when there is no Monday, I mean, it kind of, that can throw off a week a bit, so I'm going to stick more with the weeks, which most weeks have a Monday, right? But every now and then we have a holiday or something that throws it off, right? So here I'm going to look at the actual Monday to Friday group here. And now here, I didn't follow the pattern from Monday to Tuesday. In fact, it actually dropped, right? It didn't go up. It actually took a pretty decent drop here from Monday to Tuesday, all right? And dropped again here to Wednesday. But then it kind of recovered on Thursday, and then it kind of dropped off Friday, right? So this week, doesn't really seem to follow exactly that pattern, right, that we're seeing with the average. But now if we come over here, again, I see Monday, it went up from Monday to Tuesday from 66 to 69, then went up again into Wednesday, all right, and then it kind of went, dropped off a bit here on Thursday, but you still ended up a lot higher on Thursday than Monday. And I mean, I could keep going through all 90 days, but I won't do that. Just the point here is that, I mean, I generally see it following the pattern, but sometimes it doesn't. The question I think is, though, how often is it following the pattern, right? Because if it turns out that it's following it almost all the time or most of the time, then that is something to take into consideration, right? If it usually does it. And then, of course, you can use your other methods and things that you do to look and see how they agree with the typical pattern, right? So you don't just have to rely on this, but this can help you or kind of direct you and give you some ideas that you might not have thought about before, right? Here's a week that is very typical of a price increase from Monday to Friday, right? Here, 70, 73, 55, 79, 80, 83, 56. So we see again how those closing prices just keep going up. And again, you can also look at the other ones too. You can look at the open prices, see how those are going up. You can look at the lows, highs. So I'm just focusing on the closing prices right now because it's just easier to look at one thing at a time. And I want to get you used to this. But you can actually, I mean, if you're a little bit more experienced in advance and you understand you know, the different price points a little better, you can actually go ahead and start looking at the trend of what you see for all four price points, open, low, high, and close, all right, and see if they're kind of moving in unison or, you know, if one is moving up more than the other. I mean, just kind of get an idea of how this thing usually moves. So now, I mean, it doesn't mean I'm totally giving up on charting and looking at charts, but it's just that there are certain things that I can see in the data when I actually look inside of the data and look at the numbers. There's certain things I can see happening within a week, every single week, that I just can't see on a chart quite as easily, right? And then there's certain things I can see on a chart. There's certain things I can see on the chart that I cannot see very easy with data. So both have, I feel like there's an advantage to both. But basically, I think it's all useful, and you just put it all together and see how it, if it helps you with your trading. And do get a copy of this Google Sheet and let me know what you think. Let me know if you think this makes any sense, if you think it makes no sense, if you think it's helpful, not helpful. You know, just let me know in the comments, questions, or suggestions. Generally, I do believe it can give you some kind of sense of the price pattern. I mean, if you really look into it a little more. But as I said, I'll do some updates to this over time as well. So go ahead and get a copy. Subscribe to get a copy so that as I make updates or I do other things, I can actually send those things to you or at least notify you that they're available. And also subscribe to the channel so because I do plan to make more videos and I do plan to look at more of these stocks and look at the price data and give you more information on it. So definitely follow the channel. And follow the channel. Comments, questions, suggestions. You'll see my contact information below in the description of the video. This is Mr. Mark, and I look forward to hearing from you or seeing you around on the channel.